How are you? Welcome to a little bit of Celtic Thunder Radio on Alexa back there. I realize it's been quite a while since I've done a video. Kind of got out of the loop a little bit. My dad had passed away in October, and since then I really haven't been super focused on writing recipes. Really happy that at the beginning of this year we really focused back on getting into keto. I have a lot of new people that are in my keto group now, and I want to do this because I want people to understand, don't overthink it, because it really isn't hard. There's lots of recipes in my group. You'll find my recipe for the salsa that I made last week. You're just gonna have to use the search bar. So anyway, let's get started. And I am making, I don't even know what to call it because I haven't named it yet, but we love spicy hot Mexican food, and tortillas and whatnot are really not good for us. So I like to do something with, to make it quick and not overthink it. You want to keep it easy? Rotisserie chickens. They're like $6 and they're already cooked. So to my pan here, I added some avocado oil. To ensure we keep our fat level up, I'm adding some Kerrygold butter. And what I'm going to do is start the bell pepper, which is an organic green bell pepper with some orange in it and some onion. This is about, it was a large bell pepper, so this is about 3/4 of the pepper. This is about a half of a large onion. As these begin to cook down, I will then add the garlic. But just a couple quick questions for you. Do you know how you're supposed to eat asparagus? And do you know that not all of it is really that great as far as the flavor department? Asparagus has a natural breaking point, and you will find it just by breaking it, and it's literally that easy. But it's something that my mom taught me years ago, and I always remember as a kid, I despised asparagus. I thought it was the most disgusting thing. Well, guess what? It was always limp and yucky. However, I've learned that when I add it to recipes later, it actually gets really, really good. And so I personally love it. So in this bowl, I chopped up some leftover zucchini that we had. We got more asparagus there. Both of these items aren't going to take a super long time to cook, so they're going in towards the end. Same with my riced cauliflower. Yes, I riced it myself. I do not buy prepackaged riced anything. Same thing with cheese. The reason I grate my own cheese is coated with crap. It's just enough to say, because you don't know what that white stuff is that helps make it not stick. So I stood there and grated the cheese. So our veggies are starting to cook down. A little more heat. What's your favorite food? Once you guys get this video posted, I get it up on YouTube and whatnot. I'm curious to see what requests you guys may have. As that starts cooking down. Yeah, it's kind of weird. I feel kind of nervous because I haven't done one of these in a really long time. So I kind of like, am I saying the right thing? Do you like the music in the background? I'm totally into Irish music. I'll just let the food do its own talking. Too bad you don't have smell-o-vision, because smell-o-vision would make it really good, because it already smells really good in here. It was really nice of my camera person to give me a quick break there, because I'm running out of things to say. Oh my gosh, garlic, love it, love it, love it. All right, to this, as these begin to soften. Okay, so I bought the whole rotisserie chicken. It was actually still warm when we got it home, so I completely ripped it apart by hand. It's easier to do it when it's warm, not cold. Just saying it. So I ripped it up and shredded it with my hands. Aren't these dishes really cute? My mom is so awesome for Christmas up in Minnesota. I got 6 sets of dishes of all Fiestaware. I got all different colors. I totally love it. So we got our chicken in here. Now, am I the queen of Well, let me put it this way. I love spicy food. I'm not very good at measuring things because I do everything to taste. So halfway through here, you're gonna see me start tasting this to see where it's at. But like I said, we like things hot in our house, so here comes some crushed red pepper flakes. It's probably about a teaspoon. This is my favorite. Organic cayenne. So for me, this is 5 or 6 shakes, which most people probably would like 1 or 2, but I like it. Another great Mexican flavor is cumin. Alexa, volume up. Again, that's probably a tablespoon or so of cumin. And the song that Alexa's playing right now, I saw at the Chicago Theater like 2 months ago, and it was the best concert, I swear, that I have ever been to. And then this is a Fiesta seasoning mix. It's from Frontier Co-op. You can use chili powder, it doesn't matter. If it's a flavor that you like as far as Mexican food and whatnot goes, I'd run with it. So this is heating up now. And I'm gonna taste it a few different times, and because it's just for my house, I'm gonna use the same fork. Be right back. Or spoon, because we're kinda out of forks right now, I guess. And by the way, salt is not your enemy, it is your friend, especially on keto. Or hot. Because this girl, you can't make it too hot for me. I'm Scandinavian. I think I should have been born in Mexico. All right, so what we're gonna do now is adding our other vegetables. What I like to do with the cauliflower, the broccoli, and the zucchini is steam it. So I'm adding roughly 1/2 cup to 3/4 cup of chicken broth. And we're gonna bring in asparagus. And oh my God, yes, I do like it. It really isn't bad. Same with the zucchini. I don't wanna overcook this stuff for too long because I don't like mushy, soggy, disgusting vegetables. If I had broccoli, I'd add that to this. You will see as I finish it up, I'm gonna finish it with avocado and cilantro. Each new person that I know, yes, I just did that. there are people who, oh God, I did it too much, who don't know how to use an avocado, how to cut it, how to get into it, how do you do it so you can eat it and it tastes good? That avocado does help you look better vegan. I promise you not. But I'm the only one in my house that likes avocado. So I salt it. Look at that beauty. So this, because I eat 1/2 avocado every day, will go on top of my plate. So check out our food here. Need to get this, cook it on really quick, a little bit faster. Homemade salsa, I'm adding about 1 cup. This is gonna be at least 6 servings, at the very least. If you are on my page and you type in salsa, or you find the Mexican skillet recipe, which is basically this, but I did write it in a recipe. The recipe for the salsa is in the comments for sure. So you'll be sure because I put it there. We're gonna add in our riced cauliflower. Yes, I riced that myself. I don't buy eggs. Heck, if you go to the grocery store with me and you see me grab an onion, a bell pepper, I just literally set them in the basket. I don't think about it because I'm gonna wash them when I get home and I'm gonna clean them. Wish me luck if this doesn't go flying all over. Sorry. Chauncey, go. Smell it. Tell me if it smells good. Oh. Ooh, That's an iPhone 8 that's got glass on both sides. I'm sorry. Sorry about that, guys. It needs more Mexican flavor, so I'm gonna add some more cumin to it. And I'll tell you, for me, it is nice and running out of everything. Hot. We're gonna toss the cheese in here. What's beautiful about this is that we're gonna have this for dinner today, dinner tomorrow night, and it's ready. This has taken me, how long are we at in filming?
11 minutes.
Okay, and I probably spent 20 minutes prepping the vegetables and whatnot. To me, that's not too long of a time. So, for that many meals, so we're done there. So watch, this is how I serve it. And I'm not a huge eater. I mean, I am, I'm a huge foodie. Huge foodie, do not get me wrong about that. Is that I always start with small portions. And in fact, I prefer generally to use small plates, but I haven't taken a small plate out, so I used a big one. Yum. Some fresh chopped cilantro. Yes, my hands are dirty. So welcome back to Keto Cooking with Julie. I'm working on the book. It's getting there. David Fender, don't worry about it. You're gonna get it. But until then, look better naked. Drink more ketones, and bon appetit.